Hi everybody. Welcome to Tiny Tip Tuesday on this election day 2024. I am so excited to be here with you. Getting my tablet ready like I always do. So there we go. I don't see anybody popping on right now. Maybe you're all at the voting booth, which would be awesome because it's very important that we all vote. If you are a U.S. citizen, please go vote. That is the extent of my political rant today. And I know some of you who are on my personal page are like, whoo, yeah, that's all she's going to say. Phew. Yeah, I know. Okay, so today's tiny tip is going to be fun, I hope, for you and quick. I am going to be doing the fastest Christmas cards that you can make. Super simple. I know a lot of us like to send a lot, and there are some people who get our fancy-pantsy cards, and there are some people who we really want to send them a card, but we're like, we just can't make, you know, a couple hundred of the fancy ones. I mean, maybe you can, but I can't. So if you get one of the ones I'm showing you today, please understand. So let me get the advertising out of the way. To shop for Stampin' Up, go to my website, which is memoryinkers.com. That'll take you right to my Stampin' Up website. If your order is under $150, please use my hostess code for November 2024. It's M as in Mary, Q as in Queen, D as in David, 9622, V as in Victory. So, somebody's going to win today, and we are going to accept whoever wins today, because we are Americans, and we don't want to fight. Time for fighting is over, and I don't like to call it fighting. I don't know why I use that word, but whew, sometimes it felt like that. Okay, so here is my tiny tip. Get some designer series paper that you really like. Now, sometimes I look at these pages and think, is this for a scrapbook page? And then where do you put your photos? You don't cover things. So you can cut this into 6 card fronts. Now, I only have 5 because I already used this piece up here for a different card. And I'm sure I've showed it to you, but I went to look for it and I couldn't find it. But this is an awesome, set. It is from the, holiday mini. It is called Sentimental Christmas, and it's $12.50, and you get, 12 sheets. That's the side we want to look at. So this is what we're using. So, like I said, this is going to be fast. It really is going to be fast. Because I wanted to show you there's an economical way to make a lot of cards. So, get a nice holiday greeting. This is greetings of the season. We're going to be using a few of these. Get some cardstock and ink in a color that will match the designer series paper that you're using. For me, it's Pumpkin Pie and Pretty Peacock. Those are going to be for the sentiments. So, easy peasy lemon squeezy. Everybody, we're gonna do this fun. So, all of these cards, except for the ones that are going to be on basic white, will need you to cut a 4 by 5 1/4 inch piece of basic white for the inside. This piece is 4 1/4 by 5. You can put it this way, you can put it that way. I decided to make this one a landscape card, and it is going on the pumpkin pie. So, obviously, super simple. I guess I could have folded all of these before I popped on. But, all right. So, here we go. There's the front. I'm going to open up my pecan pie ink pad. And on this one, I am going to use... I'm going to look and see what fits. All right, this one fits. And it says, it's the most wonderful time of the year. Okay. Pardon my head. There you go. Super simple. I told you we're going to be super simpling it. Because why should we not, right? So here we go. We add this on there. And it's a beautiful card. And it's super simple. And there's some great sentiments in here that if you want to put them on the inside, you've got that set, right? Quick, card one. All right, now I'm going to grab, since I have this ink out, I'm going to grab my next card, which is also same color. But this one, I'm going to show you this basically same design. If you look, there are a lot of opportunities to have these Christmas trees on your card. So this one, because it has a lot of the branches in there, I decided to do it in the same pecan pie. And I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to use the same sentiment. And I'm going to put that up there like that. Now, I want to show you how different it looks when you grab different colored cardstock. So one of the things when you're planning your holiday cards is expense, right? So for this, I've got basically, depending on how many you're making, the designer series paper will probably be your biggest expense because, you know, what you're doing and how you're chopping it up. You'll get a pack of one or two different colored cardstocks or get all of the white thick cardstock, the basic white. And then a couple of ink pads and a sentiment set that you like. And super easy. You can add gems to jazz this up. But now look at this card. And we're going to do it again, only this time we're going to do it on Pretty Peacock. So I'm going to close this up. I'm going to grab, I may or may not clean the pad. Well, just hold on, because I don't know what sentiment I'm using yet. Because I really wanted this to be a kind of an on the fly. This is how quick you can make your holiday cards. So, because it's the pretty Peacock, I'm going to use the Pretty Peacock ink. And for this one, I am going to use May Your Holiday Season Be Filled With Warmth and Cheerful Celebration. Because there's plenty of space on here for me to stamp. Look at how pretty that looks. It's just so, and so simple, and yet it's just, it's so pretty. Okay, but look, these are similar, right, backgrounds, two totally different looks. This one pulls out the color of the branches is more obvious. This one pulls out the Christmas trees. Love, love, love that. So, then I have another one. Which one is it? This one. Here we go. This one, which is similar, right? It's got the branches and the trees. So I was deciding, what am I going to do with it? So I've actually cut two pieces of the Pretty in Peacock because I'm trying to decide how much I want to mat it. I don't know yet. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to grab that same sentiment. This time I'm going to pop it right in the center-ish because there's opportunity and room for that because the trees are down lower, right? So now I have to decide. This is going to go on to basic white. And I could put the DSP, designer series paper, right on the white. That's acceptable. But I did cut it shorter. And I folded this really poorly. So let me fix that. I know that never happens to anybody but me. Folding them not quite right. There we go. That's better. Okay, so I could do that, and see, that brings out the snowflakes, which is nice. Okay, these snowflakes, though, I mean, honestly, they are brighter than these snowflakes. That one's kind of bright, but so that's pretty too, just like that. But I was trying to decide how much did I want to mat this card. So there's an option where it's got a pretty fat band on it, because this is cut, it's an unusual size. It's cut 3 7/8 by 5 1/8. Okay, then this is cut, I think the normal, 5 3/8 by 4 1/8. So this is a little bit bigger, which would give me a thinner white line. But then I trimmed this one to 4 by 5 1/4, which, yeah, okay, for a second I thought I was wrong. But I decided I liked a thinner band of the Pretty in Peacock around my design, and seeing more of the white to keep those snowflakes popping. So you're going to see this is very thin. So you're going to want to play with it. You'll use your liquid glue, because you're going to get a very thin margin on this. Very thin. Okay? I'm just trying to give you different ideas. This one, because I did that, this is the most complicated card today. Who knew I'd be so complicated, right? Where's the opening? Okay. Make sure I'm putting it on right. All right. So then, see, now it's got a nice wider white band on it. But can you see? Look how different these three cards look. And they are basically the same background. These two, of course, closer than this one, but it is still the same. So, love, love, love. Okay, I have one more for you, because like I said, you can make six, but I only had five. So I've got the Pretty in Peacock again. Now, I pulled out a couple of different sentiments, but I seem to be going to the other ones. So this one is cut at 3 7/8 by 5 1/8, kind of like the other one. And I don't know why that, oh, I know what that is. Okay, and then I'm going to do white, which I believe is 4 by 5 1/4. It is. Because this time I want a thin white band. All right. And I did try putting it on the yellow. I'm trying to remember. I think it's, was it daffodil? And I didn't care for it, because I was thinking about matching the little flame in the candle. But it just, it didn't seem Christmas to me. I forgot to stamp it first, so everybody hold your breath. Not that it matters, because I've already cut the DSP. So, what are we going to put? Well, let's see. This time I'm going to do Season's Greetings. No, that's so small. This one might be too big. So this is where you play around. And see, to me, that's too big. It'll fit, but it's like then it, now it's competing with the lantern. And I don't want it to. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to use Season's Greetings right here. Super simple. So my tiny tip today is, we want to enjoy the holidays, so let's not make things too complicated with our card making. Now, that being said, y'all know me. I'm going to be showing you some fancier holiday cards over the next few weeks. But if you want to get a quick head start, here are some fast and simple cards for you today. Just fun and easy, super simple, right? So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, it's super quick. Don't forget, I'm going to remind you again, Today is Election Day in the United States. If you are a U.S. citizen, please go vote if you have not done so already. We voted early. I think I posted that to you guys. So if you want to go shopping to get your holiday stuff ready, go to memoryinkers.com. That is my Stampin' Up! Website. And enjoy the rest of your week, everybody. Bye.